Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm going to tell you about VPNs. It seems like almost everyone is using a VPN to unblock websites and protect their online privacy these days. But what exactly are VPNs and how do they work? That's exactly what we're going to cover in this video. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what is a VPN? A VPN is a service that masks your internet protocol address. This allows you to browse the internet anonymously as no one can link your data to your IP address. To understand what a VPN does, you only need to break down the words: virtual, private, and network. VPNs are virtual because they are a digital service. You don't need a cable or hardware to use them. VPNs are private because they encrypt your connection and let you browse the internet without governments, internet service providers, cyber criminals, and other onlookers scoping you out. VPNs are networks because they build a secure connection between your device, the VPN server, and the internet. VPNs are useful for people who want to use Wi-Fi in a public location that's vulnerable to hacking or spoofing, like airports, coffee shops, and co-working spaces. Browse the internet anonymously. Avoid targeted ads. Hide data from your ISP. Get a better deal on flights, hotels, large purchases, etc. Bypass government censorship or surveillance. Access geo-restricted websites and content, and protect themselves from viruses, ransomware, worms, and Trojan horses. The most common three reasons people use a VPN in 2021 were for general security, for general privacy, and to access secure networks for my job. As of early 2022, several countries have made it illegal to use a VPN, including China, Iraq, North Korea, Russia, Turkey, Belarus, and Turkmenistan. Several countries partially block VPNs, including Uganda, the United Arab Emirates, and Oman. But VPNs are 100% legal in most countries, including the United States, Australia, the United Kingdom, and New Zealand. Though VPNs are legal in many places, you can't use them to commit crimes or conceal your online activity from law enforcement. VPNs are a service for safer internet browsing, not a license to commit cyber crimes. Additionally, using a VPN may violate the terms of service on streaming services like Netflix and Hulu. If a streaming service catches you browsing through a VPN, they may cancel your membership or ban you from the platform. Streaming services have cracked down on VPN use because it violates their licensing agreements with content providers. These licensing agreements are often country-specific, so when you watch content from different countries, Netflix is technically breaking its contract. As the agreement is between the content provider and the streaming platform, the content provider could hold the streaming service responsible for showing you the content. Client-based VPNs are the tools most people think of when they hear VPN. These VPNs create a private network around a single user and a remote network through a browser extension, app, or desktop client. Some of the most popular client-based VPN providers include NordVPN, StrongVPN, and ExpressVPN. Organizations with traveling workers commonly use SSL VPNs to give people remote access to their work internet while outside the office or at home. These VPNs also allow people to use private devices to access their work network, protecting the company's network from outsiders and the employee's device from malicious actors. Site-to-site VPNs create protected bubbles around local access networks that only other approved networks can access. These VPNs are most common in large organizations with multiple locations that need to access each other's intranet. A site-to-site VPN can include multiple intranets so long as they connect to the wide area network. Your ISP and search engines track what you search for online to deliver personalized ads, offer a localized experience, and sell your data. As VPNs let you browse through a different IP address, search engines can't target you because the data is tied to the VPN instead of you. However, if you're still logged into services like Google and Facebook, they will track everything you do unless you block advertising trackers. Large companies also use techniques like device fingerprinting to track you even if you change your IP, although it's less reliable. Many cybercriminals exploit vulnerable public Wi-Fi networks to infect people's computers with malware and tracking devices like keyloggers, which record everything you type, including passwords. Specifically, cybercriminals intercept the traffic flowing across public servers and use this data to target potential victims. When using a VPN app, your VPN provider encrypts your computer's communication with the destination server. This end-to-end encryption stops cybercriminals and hackers from accessing your data. VPN services encrypt any data you send during current web activity. Encrypting this data stops governments and corporate spies from accessing any sensitive information or data that you need to share. Identity theft is an increasingly significant problem. In 2020, losses from identity theft increased 42% to $712.4 billion, up from $502.5 billion in 2019. VPNs protect you against identity theft, stopping cybercriminals from using your internet habits to steal your banking, financial, employment, and identifying data. Many e-commerce websites track your browsing behavior with cookies so that they can change prices based on your location, gender, and browsing habits. Price discrimination occurs with many things, including flights, textbooks, technology, and hotels. Using a VPN conceals your browsing behavior and location, thus preventing you from falling victim to price discrimination. Are you an avid gamer or streamer? If you want to play a game without the risk of a DDoS attack to ruin your connection, a VPN is your best bet. If nobody knows your real IP address, they can't target you. But a VPN only helps protect your personal computer and connection, not your web server or host. VPNs let you use your organization's network when working remotely, ensuring you can access your work, materials, and stay protected with your organization's security features. As VPNs let you browse the internet from a server outside your home country, you can access content that would otherwise be geo-restricted. This includes geo-restricted content on video streaming services, websites, and social media platforms. VPNs allow you to access websites and web pages blocked by your school, employer, ISP, or government. These blocks are usually applied across your local network or in a specific area, so changing your location with a VPN bypasses them. You'll need to sign up with a good VPN provider and install the VPN software or extension to start using a VPN. Once you're a member, here's how a VPN helps secure your internet connection. First, you turn the VPN software on through a button inside the app. The software will connect your computer to a VPN server, which will act as an intermediary between your computer and any servers you want to access. Many VPN providers let you select the country or city of the server so you can browse local content. Once you've connected to the VPN server, it will encrypt any data you download or upload and send it back and forth through a VPN tunnel. A VPN tunnel is a secure connection where the VPN server accesses any servers and uses end-to-end encryption to deliver or receive data from your VPN client. Your client then decrypts the data and shows you the website or content you accessed. This data still travels through your ISP, but your ISP can't see it because it's encrypted. Your ISP can only see that you're transferring data to and from the VPN server. Most VPNs have a no-log policy, so they won't store any of your web browsing data either. When you access a site or online service, the VPN server first downloads the data meant for you and encrypts it, and then transmits the encrypted data back to your computer. Then your computer decrypts the data through the VPN client or extension you use. Many VPNs also use encapsulation to wrap individual data packets in packets created by the VPN so the ISP can't make any smart guesses about what you're doing. Though this process may seem time-consuming, it only takes a fraction of a second. Your computer and VPN server will follow this three-step process countless times as you browse the internet. If you didn't know the VPN was turned on, you wouldn't notice anything unusual as VPNs run in the background. The easiest way to conceptualize how a VPN works is to imagine a package traveling via the mail. First, you wrap the package with bubble wrap and send it to the post office. The post office checks the address and sends it to your recipient. Once it arrives, your recipient unwraps the package and uses it. In this example, the package is data from a server. Bubble wrap represents encryption. The post office is the VPN tunnel, and the recipient is your computer and VPN client. The first step in selecting a VPN is to identify several potential options to compare. In 2020, the VPN market was worth $30.05 billion. And by 2027, it's expected to bring in $92.6 billion in revenue. There's a rapidly growing list of VPN options to choose between. Here are some of the most popular and established providers. When looking at VPN providers, you must separate commercial providers from individual ones. Commercial providers work with large organizations and educational institutions and companies. Individual providers focus on people who want a VPN for personal use. As of 2019, 74.1% of VPN users fit into the commercial use category. Next, research each provider to determine what features it offers. Look for these features. A no-log policy, sometimes called a zero-logs policy, states that the VPN provider won't collect, track, or log your data. Providers with this policy only store your login information and customer data, your name, email address, phone number, etc. Nothing about what you do online. Ad blockers prevent you from seeing pop-up ads, search engine ads, and website ads as you browse the internet. Ad blocking is important because cyber criminals can use ads to get you to click on compromised websites, download malware, or contact someone who will use social engineering to scam you. They also block tracking scripts that want to stalk your browsing habits on many sites. Ad blockers may also speed up your browsing experience. Research from Opera shows that when you don't use ad blockers, websites load 51% slower than when you use ad blockers. In the study, websites took an average of 3.8 seconds to load with ads and 1.89 seconds to load without ads. A kill switch immediately cuts your internet connection if your VPN connection breaks. Without a kill switch, your data would become visible to anyone with malicious intent until you reconnect to your VPN. This feature allows many users to use a single IP address. Using a single address may seem counterintuitive, but it's pretty clever. As people use the internet simultaneously, it's impossible for anyone tracking data to determine what a single user is doing online. When you browse through shared IP addresses, the people you are sharing with can't see your location data and you can't see theirs. The average US household has 10.37 devices that may need VPN protection. Other countries have fewer devices on average, with the leaders behind the US being the UK with 9.16, Norway with 8.82, and Sweden with 8.51 devices per household. Take all devices into account when selecting a VPN. Many VPN providers restrict the number of devices you can connect to the VPN on their basic plans. Look at each provider's pricing and find the best overall deal. It may be cheaper to get a VPN that works on multiple devices than to pay for a Mac, iPhone, and work computer plan. As it can be expensive for VPNs to maintain servers, some providers limit your internet access with bandwidth throttling. Check if your potential providers can handle it if you need high bandwidth. If you need to use a VPN to browse the internet in a specific country, like for video streaming, check that your potential VPN clients have servers there. In the last quarter of 2021, 54.4% of all web traffic came from mobile devices. Additionally, 46% of Americans spent 5 to 6 hours a day on their mobile phones. Though it's easy to get caught up in selecting a VPN provider for your computer, don't forget to protect your phone. Check if your potential VPN works on your mobile phone before you invest. Finally, check what operating systems your potential providers can support. If your VPN provider can't support your OS, the VPN won't work for you. The last and perhaps most crucial factor for your browsing experience is the speed and reliability of the provider's VPN servers. The VPN providers typically advertise their average speeds, but you should also look at third-party speed tests for specific countries before deciding. Finally, compare your research on each potential platform and select the platform that best meets your needs. Now that we've shared everything we know about VPNs with you, we'd love to hear your VPN suggestions. What's the best VPN in your opinion? Any free VPNs you've tried? Please tell us in the comments section below. An unsecured website puts your customers and reputation at risk. With Kinsta's Cloudflare integration, all the security features you need are built right into your plan at no additional cost. That's a monthly savings of around $200 per site. Learn more about these benefits, including DDoS protection, a more secure firewall, and more at kinsta.com/Cloudflare-integration. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.